You can now turn a photo into a video with Gemini VO 3. And yes, I may have found the key to better image to video results. Hey friends, I'm Tasia Custodi, and on this channel, I share a ton of tech tips and Google content just like this. And today we're covering a very exciting Gemini VO 3 update. And we're gonna learn how to make videos from photos in Gemini. I've been playing around with this new VO 3 update for about a week, and I'm gonna share some of those initial tests with you in a little bit, because spoiler alert, results vary. But right now, let's test a couple of these examples together on both the web and mobile so that you can see the good, the bad, and the ugly. Because Google says the whole purpose of photos to videos is to bring your images to life. So here's how to make videos from photos with Gemini on the web. Since this is a new feature, when you first open up Gemini via gemini.google.com, you might see this little pop-up letting you know you can turn images into videos with VO. You can simply click on Try Now. Don't worry if you do not see this, the same following steps will apply. From a new chat, click on Video in the prompt bar, and then here you can now click to upload an image and tell Gemini what you want to happen. So far, it does not let me drag and drop a photo, though this may change in the future. For now, you're gonna click on Add Photo, you will select the photo from your computer, and then you'll type your prompt in. So I've selected a random photo of my dinner plate because I wanna see if the food on the plate can move around and spell out, "Eat me." Let's hit Enter and we'll await the results. Now, I've found the videos usually take anywhere from 2 to 3 minutes to generate, but you don't have to stick around in Gemini. Gemini is going to work on that video generation for you, and you can simply head back in at your convenience. Like right now, for example, let's hold our breath and see how Gemini did with this image to video prompt. Okay, Gemini says it's generated a video of the food spelling out "eat me." Moment of truth, let's click play. Well, that's kind of a fail, isn't it? It did not spell out "me" correctly. It totally missed the E. And I was hoping maybe for a more stop motion animation of the food spelling out the "eat me," but I probably should have specified that in the prompt. Lesson learned. Let's try another example on the web and see if it does any better this time. And I'm gonna ask it to add audio of me speaking. And I will warn you, on all of my tests in the past week, dialogue has been completely hit or miss. So I'm gonna share those results in a little bit, but let's try this one together. I'm gonna open up a new chat from the side panel just to keep things more organized, and I'm gonna touch on some important things I've noticed with the chats in a bit. But let's follow the same exact steps here. We're gonna click video and click to upload a photo. This time, I'm going to select a selfie of me from a hike. Let's get a little more specific with this prompt. We're gonna say, "This is a photo of me hiking Camelback Mountain. Make me excitedly say, check out this view." And then I turn away from the camera and I look at the view. All right, let's hit enter. This is a big ask. And again, I could have been maybe more specific in the prompt and asked for different sound effects, but I'm trying to take baby steps with this. So let's cross our fingers and see how it did this time. All right, so I have no idea what it has me saying because there's actually no audio at all, despite me asking for specific dialogue. But it does have me turning towards the view like I asked, which is pretty cool. It even captured a ponytail for me. So if we hover over this, by the way, we can click to download to view it a little bit bigger. So here you go. As you can hear, no audio at all. So it's got my mouth moving randomly before I turn away from the camera, but we don't hear anything. No dialogue, no sound effects. And now would be a perfect time to interject with some feedback and things I've learned over the last week of testing and a really helpful prompting tip that I've noticed. The first and biggest issue is what you have just witnessed. Although image to video can produce videos with audio, it really struggles at generating any type of dialogue. So here's an example I did from last week. I took this photo of my mom and I at the tramway in Palm Springs, and I asked Gemini to create a video where both women say in unison, "Greetings from Palm Springs, we wish you were here." Watch and listen to the video I got.
"Greetings from Palm Springs. We wish you were here."
While it kind of nailed my dialogue, it had my mom talking utter gibberish. It really did her dirty. I don't even know what that was. And on top of that, I noticed yet another hiccup. I uploaded the same image again to the same chat and asked again for both women to say in unison, greetings from Palm Springs. And it just flat out could not do it for me. And no, I had not hit the limit on my video generation for the day. So there's a myriad of reasons why this glitch could have happened, but nonetheless, it actually happened to me 3 times in my testing last week. So like in this example with my dog Poppy, there's just no audio at all, even though I had asked it to give Poppy a cartoon voice and to say, boy, I sure shed a lot, don't I? And just like we saw with the video of me hiking, there's literally no audio at all, let alone any dialogue. It's also worth noting that the only ways to ask for revisions to what it's given you is to either re-upload that same photo and try again, or you have to edit the original prompt and have it try again. And be warned, if you go this route of editing the initial prompt, it's going to replace that initial output video. So please keep that in mind. The other thing you're gonna wanna keep in mind is the naming of the chats. Here's what I mean. Usually Gemini's pretty good with auto naming chats, but I have found I've needed to rename almost all of these image to video chats because usually it's giving the same chat name, like video generation in progress, which, what? It's not helpful at all. So to rename, click the 3-dot menu icon and select rename. But it simply wouldn't be fair to only rag on VO3's image to video capabilities because it's actually nailed a couple of my prompts on the first try for me right out of the gate. So let's see and hear an example of that. And then I'm gonna share a prompting tip that I think is gonna help you when it comes to your photo to video output. You know me by now. You know I'm always thinking about Halloween. So I asked Gemini to bring my skeleton to life and say happy Halloween before falling back and breaking or disintegrating into the table. And here was the very first result I got.
Happy Halloween.
You guys, that's so good. We have to give it props. And I think I found the key to better image to video results. I've found that the simpler the image and the simpler the prompt, the better video outputs, even though that goes against everything we've ever learned about prompt generation. So here's what I mean. I took this simple photo of my 11 from Stranger Things doll. This November, guys, the final installment, I cannot wait. But it's a very simple image with no other objects. It's got a pretty plain background. And my prompt here that you will notice is just as simple. Make this doll come to life. I'm purposely keeping it simple and letting Gemini just do its thing. And take a look at this result. Now that is cool image to video generation, much closer to the examples we've been seeing Google share publicly. So it seems, at least for now, simplicity is the key. All right, before we go and give our final verdict, let's see how to make videos from photos in Gemini on mobile. And yes, this works across iOS and Android as well. Though, full disclosure, when I went to screen record this the other day for you on my Pixel, it literally would not allow me to tap the gallery button. I have no idea why this glitch happened because the function is indeed back and working as of today. So, anyway. From a chat, tap on video, and here you'll tap on the plus symbol to either pull from your gallery or use your camera to snap a photo in the moment, which is very cool. So for this first example, let's just choose gallery, and I'm going to select this pic of me and my hubs and my nephew in La Jolla. And just like we did on the web, let's now prompt Gemini with what we want to see. So I want to see something like the ocean is calm and we hear the water sounds, and then a dolphin jumps in the water and we hear a splash. And then let's tap on the arrow to create it.
Wow, look at that.
It's jumping.
Amazing.
Wow, okay, that's pretty cool. So granted, I don't really know who's talking exactly, but it seems the person taking the photo might be, which is totally fine. That's kind of awesome. And in just one prompt, we've turned this photo into a video. Are our faces crazy?
Wow, look at that.
Yes. Do I really care?
Amazing.
Not really. And that brings me to my final thoughts, or verdict perhaps. The image to video generation really struggles with audio at times. Sometimes it adds audio, sometimes it's a complete silent film. There's no audio at all. It really struggles with dialogue, like almost never getting it right. And then randomly, at other times, it nails it. So if we're marking a pass-fail on audio, I would say it passes on sound effects, does a really good job there, but it completely fails on dialogue. But VO3 does really well with physical direction. So when you tell it the actual action you want it to take, like turning to or from the camera or asking for a dolphin jumping, as an example. And remember, it also seems to excel when given a simpler image and prompt, at least for now. The issue with regenerating content in the same chat and that crazy glitch I had on my Pixel, well, I'm gonna chalk it up to just that. Glitches in the matrix. Obviously, if that were to continue, we'd have a problem. But let's be realistic. We are 1 week into image to video generation in Gemini. 1 week. I think we all just need to be a little more, what's the word? Patient. And remember that hopefully this is going to improve really fast in a short amount of time. So I'm kind of impressed, even with the snags, that it's where it's at in the very earliest of stages. And remember, you can always give feedback on the generated video via the thumbs up or thumbs down button to help Gemini improve. And in terms of availability, this photo to video generator in VO3 is rolling out now to Google AI Pro and Ultra subscribers in select countries around the world. And all videos generated include 2 watermarks. There's a visible watermark to show that this video is indeed AI generated. And then there's that invisible SynthID digital watermark. So that's how to make videos from photos in Gemini. And now I want to hear from you. What will you be creating from your images to video generation in Gemini? Let everyone know in the comments below. As always, thank you so much for watching. If you like this video, well, I want to know. So give it a like, a share, or you can leave that comment below. You can click right about here to subscribe to my channel and here for even more Gemini goodness. Thanks for watching. See you next time. Just me turning my portrait into a video. Boy, it sure gave me a glow up, didn't it? Thanks for the beautiful lip filler, Gemini.